Welcome in, baseball fans, and here in New York, MLB The Show with a good one coming at you. It's the Tampa Bay Rays taking on the New York Yankees. First pitch coming your way next. Ready for baseball here in New York. And our pitcher tonight, Domingo Germán. Chris, how about a scouting report?
Try to stay back for that power changeup. Speed differential between the fastball and the changeup is huge. Hitters, they have a hard time staying back.
Now up for Tampa Bay, Yandy Diaz.
The first baseman, number two, Yandy Diaz.
The wind and the pitch. Ground ball, Rizzo picks it up. The flip to the pitcher covering. And a quick out, number one. Now a look at Kevin Cash's lineup for the Tampa Bay Rays. All right, Siggy, how about all the talent in this lineup?
They're deep, first and foremost, but the way that they can manipulate their personnel for matchups and everything else, it's very intelligent the way that they use their team. And I think it creates a little bit of uncertainty for opposing teams, especially in a big game, big series.
Wander Franco in the box now. No balls and a strike.
Well, impressed that he went right after him on that first pitch. That's the key. Try to get ahead in the count, then you can play around a little bit more as the at bat expands.
One down, base is empty. Check swing went around. Oh, a two now. Hacks and misses. It's a strikeout.
Just blown away in that at bat. Three fastballs, all strikes. He wasn't even able to foul one off. There's not much you can take away from an at bat like that as a hitter, other than maybe there's something wrong with your eyes. He's got to have better timing on the fastball next time.
And first offering is fouled off. And a pitch. Good eye right there. Way high with that one. Two balls and a strike. Tap softly third base side. A swinging bunt over to first. That ends the frame. Tampa Bay nothing. Yankees coming up. You're watching Major League Baseball exclusively on The Show. Back here in New York, and today's starting pitcher, Tyler Glasnow. Chris, what should we keep an eye on here with him?
Very solid starters, able to repeat his mechanics on a consistent basis, which allows him to move through a lineup and get deep into a ball game.
And stepping in for the Yankees, Gleyber Torres. Torres, a guy the Yankees acquired for Aroldis Chapman back in 2016.
He is fearless. You can't tell if he's been in this league for 8 years or 2 years.
Glasnow, ready to deals. And that's outside. See the velocity, 97 with that fastball. And that's in for a strike.
Out there on the mound, he's setting the tone early with the fastball, 98 miles per hour up on the scoreboard.
Righty delivers.
Ball three.
Spoils the two-strike pitch, and he'll see another.
He wanted that fastball high and tight, looking for a strikeout, just didn't locate it very well.
3-2 on the way. That one out to right. Low, hustling after it. And it hops over the wall for an automatic double.
Automatic double?
It's automatic double. It's not a ground rule double.
Well, there's something really nice about getting yourself an automatic double like that. You get to stroll into second base without having to worry about a throw or getting your uniform dirty. And now you're just looking for the next guy to kind of do the same thing. Maybe put one in the gap so you can jog home as well.
Now here's Giancarlo Stanton. Way high there. And it's 1-0. And the right-hander deals off the plate inside, and the count is 2-0. Check swing, appeal to first, and Ed Drummond right on it, says he held up. Torres stands at second with no outs. There's the strike, 3-1. Next offering is fouled back. Swing and a miss. Had him out front for the strikeout.
You know, variant speeds can be just as useful for a pitcher as movement. As you see right there, it really wasn't a great location. But the fact that the velocity change had the hitter off balance, and that's all you got to do sometimes.
Anthony Rizzo steps to the plate. In there, and it's 0-1. Runner at second here, one gone. And now the count is even.
1-1.
That one missed. And it's even up.
Two balls, two strikes.
Kicks and fires. He goes down looking.
Most guys are very aggressive when they see the stakes out there on the base paths and can't understand why he wasn't ready to swing the bat. You've got to be ready to swing the bat in a situation like that with the go-ahead run in scoring position.
Here's DJ LeMahieu. Ball one there.
One ball, no strike.
Flips the corner, and the count is 1-1. Two outs and one in scoring position. Swing and a miss. And the count 1-2.
Well, lots of pitches thrown in this first inning. It's kind of that nightmare scenario for starting pitching. But you know what? It's still early enough. He can settle in. He can get some length if he just cleans up his mechanics a little bit.
And now 2-2. Just off the inside edge.
Boog, he never moved because he never had time to. But that kind of velocity, you'd prefer that pitcher work away.
Lined into left center, and that should be extra bases. Torres rounds third, headed for the plate. He'll score, and it's 1-0.
Puts a run on the board and picks up an RBI. That ball was drilled 106 off the bat, and that's the kind of feedback that tells you you're right where you want to be with your swing mechanics.
And it's scored position with two away. And now Bader up to the plate. First pitch doesn't find the zone. Just missed.
They've got him working a little harder in this first frame than he anticipated.
Runner leads away at second. On the ground, right side. Sends it to first, and Bader is set down. And that'll keep more runs from coming in. Inning over. Yankees strike for a run on the RBI double. It's an early 1-0 lead. It's Major League Baseball, and it's on the show. And welcome back. All set for the start of the inning. Now it's Randy Arozarena. Herman back to work. And that one just missed off the outside edge. Tried to check his swing there. Now an appeal to first. And that's a swing, according to umpire Ed Drummond. That one back up the middle, and it gets through.
Just a cookie down the middle. I mean, those are the ones you dream about. The ones in the cage, you're just hoping you get in the ball game. Right down the middle, not a whole lot of velocity, right on top of it. And now they've got some speed on first, so we'll see if they try to get him into motion.
Isaac Paredes now. Tying run is at first as the Rays try and punch back down a run. And that one fouled off.
With two strikes, may see some movement over there at first base, trying to stay out of a double play here.
The pitch. Line drive, that's a base hit. Lead runner holds up. They're at first and second with nobody out.
Still able to come through behind in the count right there. You got that front foot down, and pitch recognition was on point. Pretty impressive for an 0-2 count.
Lau at the plate. Swings through that one. 0-1. And downstairs. The pitch. And a swing and a miss.
I think he was sitting off speed there.
Got him looking. Fastball to letters, frozen for strike three.
Oh, just a beautiful fastball on the inside corner for that backwards K right there. I think the hitter saw it all the way coming from that opposite arm angle. So I got to think he was looking away and just got locked up by the hard stuff boring in on his hands.
Two on, one out. And now it's Jose Siri. In the dirt, 1-0.
At the dish, looking to lift the ball in the air in this spot. Anything but the inning-ending double play, Boo.
That misses the zone, and now 2-0.
Could be some action here on this next pitch. Couple runners on, probably a challenge pitch coming.
Good hitters count the 2-0. And that one is lifted in the air. Bader should have it. Makes the catch. And there's two away.
Yeah, that was a wasted RBI opportunity. But competitor like him, he is looking forward to making up for it in his next at bat.
So next to the plate for Tampa Bay, Christian Bethencourt. This is a guy who's in the lineup first and foremost because of what he contributes defensively, Chris. And when you talk about preventing runs from being scored, this guy is a big contributor. And that one missing low. Next pitch is outside. And that's ball two.
Two balls, no strike.
Swings and misses at the breaking ball in the dirt. And a pitch. Swings through that.
Two balls, two strikes.
Arozarena on second. Paredes at first. Two out of the inning. Next pitch is downstairs. So both runners should be on the move here on the full count pitch.
Yeah, this is a good chance to tie up this ball game. See if he can find some open grass in the outfield.
Next offering is fouled back. Three balls, two strikes, the count. Struck him out looking. So the Rays strand a pair. Still behind by a count of 1-0. Back in New York, bottom half of inning number two. Here's Billy McKinney at the plate.
Billy McKinney.
The pitch. And first offering is fouled off. Glass now back to work. The 0-1. In there at the knees. Woody Keller making the calls behind home for us today.
And Boog, something to keep an eye on is how pitchers utilize the top part of the strike zone. We see a lot more of that in today's game with guys going up there with hard stuff. Keller, definitely an umpire that isn't afraid to call strikes up in that part of the strike zone.
On the ground, on the run, throw to first, and quickly one away in the second.
Batting seven, the left fielder,
Isaiah Kiner-Falefa up to the plate. In there for strike one. That's a strike.
Pretty rare location right there, right down the middle. This guy paints the edges. I'm not sure if you're going to see that pitch again as a hitter.
The 0-2. They tried to get him to chase on a slider down and away. And he deals. And that one moves his feet. Out to short. Franco on to first. Already two out here in the home half of inning number two.
That's shortstop, Anthony Volpe.
And next for New York, Anthony Volpe. That's in there, and that is strike one. Next offering misses down and away. Next one in the dirt. and misses inside. And it's ball four. He missed down low.
Pretty easy walk right there. Last pitch wasn't even much to think about.
Two outs, runner at first. Here's Jose Trevino. Glasnow picks the first. Back in safe, really close. Jose Trevino singing a Gold Glover and a guy that really does a great job presenting. Here's the pitch. Runner goes. Strike in there. And that's a stolen base, not even close.
Well, he picked over once just before the pitch to check on him, but that didn't seem to slow up his jump on the pitch at all. I think that guy's been studying some video. Awesome job to be prepared, got the timing down, and he gets into scoring position.
Runner at second, two down. Next offering is in for a strike.
And Boo, the Yankees had been looking for some stability behind the plate for a while, and Trevino stepped up in a big way, pretty unexpected as well.
Going to count one and two. Next offering is outside. Still in the second, already at 44 pitches, so some concern there.
Just trying to protect, keep the at-bat alive.
Two outs. Cuts on it and misses. That's a strikeout. Slider got him for strike three. The Yanks lead one, but they're on top 1-0. On to the third inning. Now it's the right fielder, Josh Lowe. Number 15. Lowe measures 6'4", 205 pounds, a former first-round pick back in 2016.
Well, the key to his success is getting ahead early in the count. He cannot afford to go deep in the counts. Doesn't have a ton of swing and miss stuff, so he's going to have to work efficiently.
The why to kick the pitch. That's in there.
One ball, two strikes.
And now two and two. Two, two now. Got him swinging. Couldn't catch up to the heater. The first base is number two. Yandy Diaz now. This guy makes great contact, one of the best in the game at putting bat on ball.
He's got such quick hands, and he's gaining pitch recognition. That keeps him square to the plate. There's a good chance that his bat stays in the zone a long time, and that produces solid contact consistently.
And the righty deals.
That's a strike.
Love how vocal the umpire is today. No doubt in the hitter's mind, catcher's mind, and even the pitcher's mind as to the conviction in the call.
Next pitch just misses. Now two and two. Next offering is fouled back. And that one in the air center field. Makes the grab after a long run. And there are two outs. The bat, number five. Now batting Wander Franco. 0-for-1, he struck out swinging last time. Franco throws right, bats left. 22 years old. And he was born in the Dominican Republic. And takes low for ball one.
Where do you even begin with the talent we've seen from the Dominican Republic? Vladdy, Big Poppy, Pedro, the list goes on and on.
The wind of the pitch. Way high. Next one misses, 3-1. Good plate appearance there. Able to take the walk.
Close pitch there, but you've got to forget about that call if you're out on the mound. You can't let it affect you going forward. You've got to get out of the inning first, and then if you want to be frustrated, take it out in the dugout.
Raley stands in here, takes ball one low. Left-hand batter waits. Now 1-1.
One ball, one strike.
Franco leads off first with two down to the inning. Right-hander kicks, deals. And now it's even up.
Really good take, especially with two strikes.
Swing and a miss, struck him out. The Rays strand just the one. They still trail 1-0. Welcome back. Here comes Gleyber Torres.
For the Yankees, the second baseman, Gleyber Torres.
Glasnow back to work. And a breaking ball drops in for a strike.
You know, these Yankees showing great discipline at the plate, and patience definitely seems to be the name of their game in this one. He's only given up one run, but the starter's pitch count is starting to get up there, and that might be the best news yet for this offense.
Kicks and deals. And the slider just misses.
You know, sometimes all it takes is getting to the next arm before an offense does any damage, and that might be the case today.
Goes down looking. Giancarlo Stanton at the plate. Struck out swinging his first time. First pitch, and that's in for a strike. Giancarlo Stanton, who won the National League MVP in 2017 and then was traded immediately to the New York Yankees.
Yeah, the last two players to win the MVP and then be traded were both traded to the New York Yankees. Alex Rodriguez, Giancarlo Stanton.
The 1-1. That one is upstairs. Kristen, remember, Giancarlo Stanton won the 2016 Home Run Derby at Petco Park.
Yeah, he made that place look like a wiffle ball field.
Swing and a miss. And it's 2-2. Here's a 2-2. Got him. That's his second strikeout.
Well, big power guy right there and generating so much bat speed. It's hard to bring that to a halt once you've committed. He tried to check the swing, just couldn't do it.
Two outs, bases empty. Anthony Rizzo stepping in now for the Yankees. Rizzo, a member of the 1,000 Hit Club, and he's a former National League Gold Glover. On the ground, right side. Diaz takes it himself, inning over. Yanks held in check, but they lead it 1-0. here at New Yankee Stadium in the Bronx. John Ciampi with Chris Singleton, and set to lead off the fourth, Randy Arozarena. And the right-hander back to work. That one ripped left field. Bangs off the wall. Into second base. The tying run is on with a leadoff double.
I'm sure he feels really good about that one. Just missed out on a home run right there, but he certainly hit it hard enough. Just didn't have the right launch angle to carry it over the wall, but still an excellent swing of the bat.
So digging in, Isaac Paredes. And he's already singled in this game. That one's in there, 0-1.
As a pitcher, you know the runner on second is ready to push things with his speed. A base hit's probably going to be a big run, so you really have to execute on the mound.
Here comes the 0-1. Bounced up the middle. Oh, great stop. Throws it away.
That's a dangerous throw for the first baseman to try to handle right there. Exposed him to a potential collision, and we've all seen some of the ugly ones over the years on plays similar to that one. So it's great. Nothing came out of that other than the throwing error.
And now it's Brandon Lau. Struck out looking in his first at bat. That's a little bit low. Next pitch is outside.
I think ultimately you want to tie him up, get the ball in on the plate so that he can't get the barrel to it and hit it to the outfield.
That's off the mark, and it's 3-0.
This is a situation where the hitter is looking for something up in the zone that he can get his arms extended. What you have to be careful of is that pitch that's up, that's in on your hands. That'll pop you up in the infield, and that's exactly what the pitcher wants.
Let's see if he gives him anything to hit here.
Back-to-back fastballs in. That last one called for a strike. Probably go away, but look for him to come back in there to try to finish you off.
Right down the chute. Now 3-2.
Well, in this situation with a runner on first, less than two outs, some say, hey, get the ground ball, double play with two strikes. Some people say get the strikeout. I think you just execute your...
Struck him out looking. Called strike three and a fastball up in the zone. And now, Jose Siri. And that's in there for strike one.
In this situation, the batter's got to know what the pitcher's trying to do to him, and that's trying to get him to hit the ball on the ground, get two for one. You got to look for something up in the zone, and worst case scenario, you deliver the sacrifice fly.
Check swing, now a look down to first. No swing, just held it back there. Here's a 1-1. Swings and chases a low one there.
Big pitch right here. He's going to try to make a pitch that's going to produce a strikeout or a ground ball double play.
Runners are at the corners, one away. To third might be two. Over to Torres. Got him. The double play cuts down the potential tying run.
Well, we can never overstate it. Pitcher's best friend right there. Double play, gets out of the jam, saves some pitches.
Ready to go, bottom four. Go. DJ LeMahieu to start it off.
DJ LeMahieu.
Here comes a pitch. And first offering is fouled off. And here it comes. And now the count is even. Chris, DJ LeMahieu, given name David John LeMahieu. Some people call him by the nickname the Big Fundy.
What's the Big Fundy, partner?
Well, it's short for the Big Fundamental because he's so good fundamentally, both at the plate and in the field. Hauls it in for the out.
Now got it. Center fielder.
Harrison Bader, the next to hit, rolled out to second in his first at bat. In there, and it's 0-1. Singing four homers in 22 games at Old Yankee Stadium. What do you remember?
Well, I remember my rookie year hitting two in one game. And, you know, before that game in the clubhouse, there was a gentleman there who owned a suit company there in downtown Manhattan. And he said to me, hey, kid, you hit a home run in the game tonight. Come over to the store tomorrow and I'll give you a free suit.
Righty to the plate. And 1-2.
So I went into the game. I happened to hit two. When I walked into the store the next day and he looked at me, he said, you're trying to put me out of business, aren't you? And that was a great experience that I had as a rookie playing against the Yankees, playing in New York.
The pitch. Swing and a pop up in foul ground. Bethancourt moving under it. And there's two down. So did Super Joe give you two suits?
Now Super Joe hooked me up with two suits.
McKinney.
Two outs, bases empty. And up next for New York, Billy McKinney. Grounded out his first time. And a foul ball. One. That ball. One missed.
1-1.
Falling ball. Behind 2-1.
Just missed with a good breaking ball in. Looking for that hitter to chase and perhaps get some weak contact or a swing and miss. Good job on both sides.
The 2-1. And there's a ball.
First pitch strike from the pitcher, but then no panic at all by the hitter. Very patient, showing good discipline. Now he's in the driver's seat with the 3-1 count.
The 3-1. Swing and a foul straight back. Got him looking. That's a strikeout. Down in order, go to Yankees, but they still lead it 1-0. Back here at the ballpark, ready now for the fifth inning. And now the catcher for the Rays, Christian Bethancourt. The pitch. And ball one.
One ball, no strike.
Check swing, no appeal. Ball two. The wind of the pitch. That one's spoiled, and the count now 2-1. Righty delivers. Pop foul out of play off to the right. Two on the way. Check swing. Appeal to first. No, he held up. Here comes a 3-2. And that's ball four.
That could jumpstart an offense that's really struggled to score in this one. Don't want to wake a team up with a free pass.
No outs. Runner at first. Now here is Josh Lowe. He's 0-1. First pitch, and that's in for a strike.
And I know you want to be patient as a hitter, but you got to be ready to jump on the first thing straight. And he got one right there, but left the bat on his shoulder.
Deal one.
Ball.
Bethancourt aboard here at first with nobody out. Next pitch is outside.
2-1.
Bounced, and that got the pitcher. Not in time, he legs it out. Definitely some concern here. That ball came back and got him right on the pitching arm, as you can see him trying to shake it off.
And if nothing else, you worry about him getting some dead arm and losing some feeling, but from what I can tell, I think they're going to let him continue, and that's a really good sign.
So the Rays batting order turns over. Yandy Diaz next to hit for the Rays. First pitch, and he just misses. And the right-hander deals. And the 1-0 misses low.
Way to lay off that pitch down.
Turned on, but foul wide of third. And a big swing and a miss. That missed inside, and the count is filled up. Wander Franco up next for the Rays. No outs, runners at first and second. Swing and a pop-up. Foul territory for the catcher. Makes the grab, one away.
Good hard fastball up in the zone right there. They look really good coming in, but so hard to get on top of as a hitter.
Here's Wander Franco.
Definitely wants to stay out of the double play here. Ball on the ground in the infield. Should be an inning-ending double play. The last thing he wants is to hit the ball on the ground, but I wouldn't expect many pitches up in the zone. They'll be pitching for a double play in this spot. He's pitching well, but not throwing a ton of first pitch strikes. Usually doesn't work out for success, but you can never predict baseball.
And he deals. And there's a curve through for a strike.
Oh, this guy's so comfortable hitting with two strikes. Even a good pitch early in the at-bat. If he's not ready to pull the trigger, he's not worried if he gets to an 0-2 count.
Kicks and fires. Caught him looking for the K.
Just locked him up right there for the second out, and that's an at-bat he's probably going to be thinking about for a little while. Didn't pull the trigger. Not how you want to go down in an RBI spot, so now you got to hope your teammate behind you can pick you up.
So first and second with two outs. Next is the designated hitter, Luke Raley. High fly ball lifted in the air right field. Makes the play, and it's out number three. So the Rays strand a pair, and it remains 1-0. Back now in the Bronx, here's the left fielder, Isaiah Kiner-Falefa. And the pitch. And downstairs. And now 2-0. It's the slider in there for a strike.
Man, 91 on the slider right there. That's a hard one. That's a low-end fastball for some guys.
And a pitch. Swing and a miss. And the count is 2-2.
Just not able to catch up to that velocity.
Next offering misses, and it's 3-2. That one drilled left field. A Rosarena going back, racing back some more. Pulls it in on the warning track.
Man, I love that route. The ball was smoked. He knew he had to get back to the track right away. Turned his back on the infield. Got to the spot, turned around, and made a nice catch.
Volpe, the next to hit, takes ball one.
One ball, no strike.
That one's in there. And 1-1.
For you growing up in New York City, being you're a big sports fan, tell me about your experience with the Yankees growing up.
I really went to Shea Stadium more than I did to Yankee Stadium. I grew up a Phillies fan. There was one game, though, that I went to as a kid. I sat in the upper deck. It was the game that Bo Jackson hit three homers in his first three plate appearances and then hurt his shoulder diving for Deion Sanders inside the park home run. That's probably the most memorable game that I ever attended as a fan at Old Yankee Stadium. Swing and a high fly ball out there towards left field, and there's two down.
Just pulled off of it a little bit right there. That front shoulder coming open instead of staying closed. If he does that, he's going to be able to go up the middle the other way with some authority instead of a fly out to left.
Trevino takes a ball as he stands in for the second time.
Oh, he's got to be pretty proud of this outing so far. Sometimes guys cower coming into a ballpark like this, but he has attacked hitters. Pitching on the road like this is very impressive. This has been a treat to watch.
Action in the pen down there. Kevin Kelly warming up for manager Kevin Cash. Armstrong getting loose as well. Bounced up the middle. In plenty of time to first. That's the third out. Inning over. So the Yanks go in order. They lead it 1-0. Top six. Now here's the Tampa Bay cleanup hitter, Randy Arozarena. Arozarena, 28 years old, and he's a former Rookie of the Year. That one misses in the dirt. And a swing and a miss there.
1-1.
The 1-1. Chopped on the ground. They get the out on a Rosarena. Now Isaac Paredes next to hit for the Rays. 1-2. First pitch just misses. On the ground to the left, and it goes just foul. Swing and a high fly ball to left. He's there. He's got it. And there are two down.
The batter is second baseman, Brandon Lau.
So two down now, and here is Brandon Lau, who's 0-2 with a pair of strikeouts. That one's in there, 0-1. Missed inside with the curve. The 1-1. Just ball. Missed.
2 balls, 1 strike.
Now, there's a pitch we haven't seen in a while. It's going to be tough on the hitters if he can mix that in whenever he wants.
Left-hand batter waits. Good eye right there.
Hold down.
That one the other way. He's got it, and that'll end the inning. Offense held in check there. Top of the order due up in the home half of the sixth. Yankees 1, the Rays nothing. Well, we go bottom six. Leading here up, is Gleyber Torres.
The second baseman, Gleyber Torres.
And the pitch. Strike one.
You know, these Yankees doing a great job, Boog, of just waiting for the right pitch to come their way. And I'm seeing very patient at bats out of them. Feels like almost every at bat has gone full. They've worked a full count 6 different times. And that's the main reason his pitch count is so high right now.
At the belt and fires. Late swing fouled off. Oh, and 2 now. Swings through it, and that's a strikeout.
Well, take a look at the 3-pitch sequence here. Pretty simple in terms of putting them away at the plate. Once you're ahead 0-2 as a pitcher, you can really expand the zone and see how aggressive that hitter is going to be trying to protect and battle. And right there, clearly he was in swing mode, but all you can do is hope to foul that off.
And now it's Giancarlo Stanton. Here's a high chopper. Over to Diaz. And a couple of quick outs.
Up next to the Yankees, the first baseman, Anthony.
And here is Anthony Rizzo. With Anthony Rizzo, you almost forget he was originally drafted by the Red Sox. He debuted with the Padres, won that championship with the Cubs, and now a Yankee.
Yeah, and I think one of the telltale signs early with him in terms of the guy that would have that intestinal fortitude is just the fact that he beat cancer. And it really looks like these hitters have been in between with their timing today. Good fastball, excellent slider, but they've not been able to commit to one velocity and stay there.
1 ball, 1 strike.
Next pitch misses, and a count 2-1.
I always remember watching Johan Santana pitch, and when he was in his prime, you would see a lot of guys out in front, right-handers pulling that changeup in the stands, and then fouling the fastball the opposite field up into the stands.
Now a bullet to second base, but he's got it to end the inning. Yanks held in check, but they hold a 1-0 lead. We go to the top of the seventh. Here's the center fielder, Jose Siri. Herman back to work. In the air, foul off first. Rizzo has this one sized up, hauls it in, and there's one away. Next to hit, Christian Bethencourt, known for his rocket arm behind the plate. And the first pitch misses for ball one. Activity in the bullpen for the Yankees. Michael King getting loose out there for Aaron Boone. Peralta, the power lefty, up as well. Let's go, The pitch. Swing and a miss. And a count 1-1.
Not sure if he could be in more of a groove. Looks really relaxed. He's retired 7 straight. This guy's feeling it right now.
And that one is lifted in the air. McKinney under it. Makes the catch for the out.
Just one out away from 7 strong innings and just at 100 pitches. Man, pretty impressive. They've got to be happy with what they've gotten from him out there today.
And now the right fielder, Josh Lowe.
Now just about to hit that century mark, 100 pitches for this game.
And that is in for a strike. And it's 0-1.
Well, I'm impressed with that challenge pitch right there. Even with this slim lead, this guy's not afraid to go right after these hitters.
Strike 2.
1-2.
Swing at a ball lifted to center field. Bader puts the squeeze on that one, and that'll end the inning. Down in order go the Rays. They're down 1-0. So out of the pen comes the right-hander, Kevin Kelly.
And this could be a pretty critical point in this game. They're hoping he's the guy to keep them within striking distance.
DJ LeMahieu to start things off. 1-for-2 with an RBI double back in the first. And a pitch. That one fouled off. The pitch.
1-1.
Top of the zone for a strike, and the count is 1-2. And the 1-2 misses to even the count.
2 balls, 2 strikes.
The 2-2. Got him looking. And one away in the bottom of the 7th.
Well, oftentimes that's the pitch he's trying to set off, the curveball. He'll lean on it pretty heavily, so you got to be expecting it. Look for it and sell out so you don't miss it when you get it.
Digging in, Harrison Bader. And that one off the outside edge.
1-0.
And the righty deals. Just off the outside edge. 2-0.
He hasn't wanted to challenge him. Both of those pitches off the plate away. Don't expect anything down the heart of the plate. You may just have to be patient and take your walk here.
That one close, ruled a ball. 3-1 now. And foul ball. And he grounds one to the right side. Tosses to first. 2 up, 2 down.
Good fade and sinking action of that changeup. Got that hitter to roll over. Billy
McKinney. 2 outs, base is empty. And stepping in for the Yankees, Billy McKinney. First offering, no, and it just misses. And another ball. And a foul ball makes the count 2-1. Two down, nobody on.
Ball, no.
This is a really good feeling for a hitter. At this point in the ball game, you know that they don't want to walk you, so you're going to get a pitch to hit. You just better not miss it.
Right-handed reliever.
Full count.
Slice the other way. That's a base hit.
Love how he let that ball travel, trusted his hands. Nice job of going the other way.
Runner at first with two away. Now the left fielder, Isaiah Kiner-Falefa.
Almost drove one out of here last time up. Flied out to the warning track.
And first offering is fouled off. McKinney off of first with two away. The other way, makes the grab, and that'll end the inning. Pitching change here, Michael King.
Well, the best relievers love the opportunity to come in and protect the tight lead late in the ball game. Some of them are just wired different, so we'll see what he's got here.
So digging in, Yandy Diaz. The wind of the pitch. That misses off the outside edge. Movement in the Yankees' pen. Clay Holmes getting loose out there for Aaron Boone. Two balls, no strikes to count. On the ground to third. LeMahieu gets it to first, and that's one away as the leadoff man is out in the eighth.
That's why you hug the lines on the corners late in a ball game like this, positioned perfectly.
Now Wander Franco, a strikeout and a walk. That one pushed to the left and foul. And the 0-1. Line to right, base hit. So they get a man aboard with a one-out single.
Well, that was an important at-bat this game, so a great job there stepping up to the challenge. That was one of those swings that feels like you're swinging an aluminum bat. It jumped off so hard, squared it up, and it went screaming at 108 miles per hour.
One down, and now Luke Raley. First offering misses badly for ball one.
If you're a base runner, you got to stay dialed in here. Look for anything in the dirt. Try your best to get into scoring position.
Next offering is down low. With a single base runner, because of all the power, they are dangerous to tie this thing up or take the lead. That one's spoiled, and the count now 2-1.
Pretty good pitch there to take a rip at. He wants to get his arms extended. He likes the ball away from him a little bit, just not able to square it up.
The 2-1. Runner on the go. Next offering is foul back. checks the runner. Franco dives back in safely. Two down. Swings and misses, struck him out. Couldn't hit the fastball at the knees.
It came out of his mechanics there. Typically likes to shoot the ball the other way, but that time, a little anxious.
Randy Arozarena next to hit for the Rays. First pitch, and he just misses. King throws over, and he's back in safely. The 1-0. A swing and a miss, and that's strike one.
He's been great in this one. Eye-hand coordination just failed it.
Runner on the go. Pitch is high. Throw is low, and he can't pick it. Next offering, pop foul off to the right out of play. That one just misses the outside corner. And a full count now. Struck him out looking.
A lot of adrenaline, we can see it right there, and sometimes you just got to let it out. That's an outstanding job of taking that, executing, and getting out of a tough inning.
Sean Armstrong takes over on the mound.
Just trying to keep this one close here, and this is where a bullpen can give their guys a chance to fight back into the game.
And stepping in for the Yankees, Anthony Volpe.
The shortstop, Anthony Volpe.
And here it comes. And there's a strike.
Well, don't expect too many more high fastballs. This is a good sinker ball pitcher, and sometimes they can make mistakes trying to pitch up in the zone. Look for him to stay down around the knees to be effective.
The next offering misses, and it's 1-2. High fly ball, right field. Lowe has it sized up. He's got it. One away.
The batter, the catcher, Jose
Trevino, stepping in now for the Yankees. This guy, one of the best defensive catchers going. You talk about framing. The ability to block, catch, and throw, he is at the top of the game. And that's in there for strike one.
Really good athlete, and many times we talk about, you know, the feet of infielders. This catcher as well, really quick feet. He's able to recognize the pitch, see the trajectory, and get into a spot where he can block those balls and keep them from going to the backstop.
And the 0-2. Up the middle, and that one finds its way through. And that turns the lineup over.
Really nice job of two-strike hitting in that at-bat. Timing on the swing was good. Able to shoot the ball up the middle. Didn't square it up as much as he probably would have liked, but that's a good approach paying off.
Gleyber Torres up to the plate.
Three-pitch strikeout last time up. Got to put up more of a fight in this one.
In there for strike one.
Really impressive with the way he frames, the way that he sets it up, because sometimes those pitches are off the plate, but because he sets up and presents it so well, he steals strikes for his pitcher.
Next pitch is outside, and now it's even 1-1. Let's go, Next offering is in for a strike.
One, two.
Trevino leads off first with one away. Swing and a miss, and he is down on strikes for the third straight at bat.
Third time he struck out in this one, and definitely an individual performance you want to flush. He just hasn't looked very comfortable up there. Just one of those days. But when you're still winning the ball game, at least you can focus on doing your part to maintain that lead and getting that W.
Stanton stands in now and watches strike one. Kicks and deals. That one pushed foul. Righty to the plate. Swing and a miss. Struck him out. And that is that. So they turn to their closer, Clay Holmes. And this guy can bring it velocity-wise.
Clay.
So digging in, Isaac Paredes. One for three. The pitch. Ball one, no strikes. Right-hander kicks, deals. And there's a foul ball. The tying run at the plate. That's three there for a strike. Another 1-2. Ground ball right side. Collected by Torres. In plenty of time to first. Now one gone in the ninth.
Good arm side run and sink on that pitch right there. Got inside on him and got him to bounce into that out.
Now it's the second baseman, Brandon Lau.
A lot of times you're looking for a guy to get that tie and run on base. But because of the power, you want him to tie up the game with one swing here.
And the first pitch misses for ball one.
One ball, no strike.
And that's in for a strike.
Just amazing to me how many closers and back-end relievers just throw absolute gas these days. I never would have had a chance.
Gonna count 1-2.
Good late sink on that fastball. Out of the hand looks so good, and then by the time he gets in the hitting zone, hard to get the barrel to it.
Next pitch inside. The count now 2-2. Crowd locked in right now. One run game here in the ninth. Hard grounder into the outfield for a knock. A perfect example right there. That plate discipline, it pays off.
The deeper he gets into a count, the more comfortable he becomes, and he usually wins the battle.
He's two outs away. And stepping in for the Rays, Jose Siri. Outfield deep here, trying to prevent anything over their heads. Swung on, belted. That one carrying. Banks off the wall. Throw back in as the tying run holds at third. Two on following the double.
Didn't take long to get a result for that at bat. He hit that ball really well to deep right field right there. Got a pitch to drive and just stayed through it nicely. Didn't quite have the trajectory to clear the fence, but you're always happy with an extra base hit. Now that sets up a huge at bat in this ball game.
And here is Christian Bethencourt. Inside corner for a strike. Going one.
Don't be surprised, a ball on the ground to the corners, that they come home with the baseball instead of going to first base.
And now the 0-1. Good eye right there.
This is the guy they turn to get the most important outs of the ball game, but they're going to make him work to get this save.
And a 1-1. They tried to get him to chase on a slider down and away. The count 2-1. Inside, just missed. Josh Lowe in the on deck circle. Two on, one out. And that one fouled off. And he walked him.
Walks out of the bullpen can absolutely kill your momentum. Very quickly, they're in some hot water trying to protect this lead.
Now up for Tampa Bay, Josh Lowe. On the ground, down the line, and it's foul. One out. The possible tying and go-ahead runs on base. Line drive, base hit. One runs in. Rowe comes into third. Pulls into third safely. As two runs score, they've got the lead.
Solid swing from start to end, on time with everything, really good balance, nice extension, and he met it out front for the line drive knock.
Tommy Kahnle taking over on the mound.
Pretty tight game, so they're looking for quality pitches out of him right here. Got to do his best to keep the score right where it is.
Number 41, Tommy Kahnle.
Yandy Diaz next to hit for the Rays. Swing and a foul straight back. 2013 in the playoffs, you caught one as the Red Sox played the Rays in a division series.
I sacrificed a bracelet. It was my wrist and my hand.
The 0-1. A little bit low. Meanwhile, activity in the bullpen. Number 97 getting loose out there for Aaron Boone. And the right-hander deals. So a foul ball makes it 1-2. The pitch. And down on strikes. Now two out. So next to the plate for Tampa Bay, Wander Franco. And that one just misses a ball and no strikes. Swings and pulls it foul to the right side. The 1-1. Foul back our way, and that's out of play. Swings and misses, struck him out. A couple of runs in the inning puts them ahead. Hard of the order. 3-4-5 will get their shot in the bottom of the ninth. It's the Rays 2 and the Yankees 1. So the closer summoned from the bullpen, Pete Fairbanks.
And we all know about his slider. It's just filthy, man. And one of the better ones in the game, I'd say. Spin rate's very high, and it just breaks a ton.
3-4-5 due up for the home team. And stepping in for the Yankees, Anthony Rizzo. Here comes a pitch. And that one wrapped foul. Here comes the 0-1. To the right side, Lau. Tosses to first. Rizzo out of the play.
Couple of pitches and a quick out.
The third baseman.
Now it's LeMahieu up to hit. First pitch, and that's in for a strike. Inside, just missed. A one-run lead, and the home team trying to pull it out. Righty delivers. Got him swinging for the strikeout. Slider got him for strike three.
Definitely made him chase a little bit out of the zone right there. I don't think that's a strike if he takes it. Pretty textbook pitching. Get ahead in the count. Get the guy in the box on his heels and then force him to chase your pitch where he doesn't have much of a chance to do any damage.
So last chance for the Yankees. And now the center fielder, Harrison Bader. First pitch just misses.
You know, this guy's great speed is in the back of that pitcher's mind. If he can get on, it's going to give him one more thing he's got to think about.
Home team down a run here in the last half of inning number 9. There's the strike. They're down to their final strike. And it's even up. And delivers outside.
Big pitch coming right here. Last thing he wants to do is put the tying run on base, but he can't groove on either.
Got him! And that's the ball game.
All game, these guys had to battle with that 10th man, those fans making a lot of noise, but they took the lead in the ninth inning, quieted things down, and were able to get those final three outs in the bottom half as well. Just a very well-executed ball game.
And your final score here today, 2-1. For Chris Singleton and our entire crew here at MLB The Show, thanks for stopping by. I'm John Ciambi. Talk to you soon.
The final line score for our ball game tonight. For the victorious Rays, two runs on eight hits, no errors. They left 10 men on base.